When Destiny came out, everyone I knew was crazy excited for it, me included. I loved Halo, and I had some high expectations for the new IP. Now, don't go crazy here, internet, but I didn't like Destiny 1. I actually kinda hated it. It was awful to me. No real story, clunky mechanics, and a bunch of tedious tasks to do. I know that's not a popular opinion, but I don't care. That's just my thoughts. So if I disliked the first game so much, why on God's earth would I buy the second one? I don't know. Somehow I was convinced, and to that guy or girl, we're all equal opportunity here at Will's Game Reviews. Hashtag feminism. Actually, it was Lyle. Lyle made me buy the game. So if I hate this game too, I blame him. Here we go. Destiny 2 actually has a story to it. And I don't mean whatever that mess in the first game. I mean a legitimate, well-written, mildly entertaining characters, all of the shebang. There's a real conflict, a proper resolution, and likable characters. Cade has some of the best lines I've heard recently.
Quick, hurry, come on, I don't know how long this portal's gonna stick.
Cade? What have you?
Stop. Look, long story, and it may look like I don't know what I'm doing, but I do. Maybe not, doesn't matter. Killing the power source at the origin point should break the loop and get me out of the portal system. Have you got that? Say you've got it.
Say something! Fine, I'll say it. We got it, Cade. Now how did you...
Oh my god! Zox, did you not hear what I just said?
Our son.
Hey, easy. You're gonna blow our boat.
It's not really anything special as a story, but it does play the role nicely, flows well, and didn't confuse me nearly as much as the first one. The story does take a backseat to most things in the game, but I'm okay with that for the most part.
Allow me to reacquaint you.
There is a ton of different stuff to do, and the PvP and raids and stuff could take up its own video. So that's gonna come at a later point, cause I'm swamped with work and haven't really had time to invest in that enough to review it. So, sorry if that's what you guys wanted, go check out another video or something. Anyways, Destiny is a first-person shooter just like its predecessor. The game incorporates a nice mix of RPG elements along with a bit of an MMO mix to it. Having the MMO part within the story is still kinda weird to me. You're just running along trying to kill your way through the mission, and suddenly you have strangers beside you. The game does provide a bit easier way of getting with your friends though, with the use of self-made clans, which is a huge bonus. You level your guardian through the game, which allows you to upgrade your skill tree and use stronger armor, increasing your light level. What I find odd is even after putting all the work of grinding levels to finish the game, once you beat the game, it just maxes you out. I'm not sure if I like it or not, to be honest. In one sense, it's nice not to have to finish the grind and just get boosted right to the max. But in another, it's like, what the hell was the point of all the grinding in the first place then? Destiny 2 features the same three character classes as the original. Each class has their own specific upgrades, perks, and special abilities, and three subclasses that allow players to finely tune their individual characters to provide a different playstyle. It brings a lot of great variety and replayability to a fairly short game where you can max out characters with very little effort. While exploring the worlds and completing missions, you can also find yourself in public events, which are basically quick missions that a group of people or individual can do, granting you some extra experience and some rare loot. One of the best things about the game is that if you get an exotic weapon or armor with great abilities, but you find armor that's stronger, you can dismantle it and add those effects to your stronger armor. I love this ability because it makes you getting a rare weapon early in the game not feel completely obsolete by post-game. The actual gameplay is fairly straightforward. It feels no different than any other first-person shooter. You have varying different guns, pulse rifles, submachine guns, so on and so forth. And then you have a punch and a grenade. It's pretty straightforward, fundamentally sound, and overall nothing really to complain about. This is where I think the biggest improvement in the game is from its predecessors. Aesthetically speaking, it looks so much better. Not graphically, but environmentally. It just feels more inclusive. The worlds feel alive, way more than they ever did in the first game. The writing is much better and creative, with more voice acting and enthusiasm to it. You still spend a solid chunk of time in caves that essentially look the same, but overall the game does not look and feel nearly as bland as the original. The story certainly doesn't take long to complete. but there's no shortage of things to do. You have your side missions, unlocking your subclasses, and of course the strikes and raids. Along with that, the replayability of the game with new characters can help keep players going, which sort of offsets the $80 that every bloody game is now. Destiny 2 is much improved from the first game, at least in my opinion. The entire feel of the game just seems better to me. I'm not that big into FPS games anymore. I had that phase and moved on, but FPS games like this that incorporate a strong RPG element and a half-decent story are still worth playing.
In about Cajun, I saw the constellation.